A very good morning students, welcome to the second session of halogen compounds. In these sessions we are going to learn about the preparation of alkyl halides. We know that alkyl halides are of two types, right? Aliphatic alkyl halides and aromatic alkyl halides. So we are going to learn about the preparations of both aliphatic alkyl halides and aromatic alkyl halides. In addition to this, let us learn about elimination reactions also. In this session we'll cover these two topics, right? Let me start the preparations of alkyl halides. In these preparations of alkyl halides, let me first start the preparations of aliphatic alkyl halides, right? Let me start the preparations of aliphatic alkyl halides. Aliphatic alkyl halides can be prepared in number of ways. Let us learn the two ways. So aliphatic alkyl halides can be prepared from alkanes and from alcohols. So first let us write the preparation from alkanes. If you take methane treated with chlorine in the presence of photolyte, you will get methyl chloride. And if you add chlorine again in the presence of photolyte, the reaction continues, CH2Cl2, and again the reaction further leads to CHCl3, and further this will give CCl4. This reaction has already discussed in the classification of alkyl halides, right students? I have discussed there. So when you treat methane with chlorine in the presence of photolyte, you will get a series of alkyl halides. The name of this alkyl halide is methyl chloride. This one dichloromethane. This one chloroform. And finally carbon tetrachloride. In this way, by using photolyte, we can easily prepare alkyl halides. Next from what students? From alcohols. So the second reaction is from alcohols. For example, if you take ethyl alcohol, the formula of ethyl alcohol is CH3CH2OH, and treat it with PCl3. We need 3 moles of alcohol to treat with PCl3. So 3 moles of ethyl alcohol treated with PCl3 results in 3 moles of ethyl chloride. 3 moles of ethyl chloride. What will be the byproduct, students? The byproduct will be PH3PO3, phosphoric acid, H3PO3. If you take same alcohol, ethyl alcohol, and treat it with PCl5, here only 1 mole is enough. 1 mole of ethyl alcohol react with PCl5 to give CH3CH2Cl, ethyl chloride plus POCl3 plus HCl. These are the byproducts. If you treat ethyl alcohol with SOCl2, thionyl chloride, the product will be CH3CH2Cl, ethyl chloride plus SO2. So using alcohols, using 3 different reagents, PCl3, PCl5 and SOCl2, we can easily prepare alkyl halides. In this case we are preparing ethyl chloride. These are the 2 preparations of aliphatic alkyl halides. Now next let us see the preparations of aromatic alkyl halides. Take down the heading, aromatic alkyl halides. Students, please make note of every reaction. Students, you have to make your own notes, right? Write down the heading: aromatic alkyl halides. Aromatic alkyl halides can be easily prepared by the halogenation of aromatic compounds. We studied in first semester when benzene is treated with chlorine, Friedel-Crafts halogenation. Do you remember? When benzene is treated with chlorine, you will get chlorobenzene. In the same way, if you take toluene is nothing but you contain CH3 group on the benzene ring. When toluene is treated with chlorine, you boil this solution, then you will get benzyl chloride. This does not stop here. This continues. So further treatment, you will get dichloro derivative, and on further treatment, you will get trichloro derivative. You will get a series of reactions for aromatic alkyl halides. When you take toluene and treat it with chlorine, boil these solutions, you will get mono halo, dihalo, trihalo derivatives, right? Let us see the second preparation. You can easily prepare from aromatic alcohols also. If you take aromatic alcohol, right, students, can you guess the reactions? With what does aromatic alcohol should be treated? You can use, as in the case of you used aliphatic alkyl halides, in the same way for aromatic alkyl halides also you can use PCl5 and SOCl2. When you treat it with PCl5, you result in benzyl chloride, CH2Cl. And if you take aromatic alcohol, CH2OH, again treated with SOCl2, again you will result in benzyl chloride, right? You can write down these three preparations. So aromatic alkyl halides can be easily prepared from toluene by halogenation and from alcohols using the reagents PCl5 and SOCl2. These are about the preparations of alkyl halide, students. And there is one interesting named reaction, students, from which we can prepare both aromatic alkyl halides and aliphatic alkyl halides. There is one interesting reaction we can prepare aromatic alkyl halides and aliphatic alkyl halides. Pronounce it, students, Hans-Steiker reaction. Using these Hans-Steiker reactions, we can easily prepare aromatic and aliphatic alkyl halides. And the Hans-Steiker reaction is also known as Borodin reaction. Hans-Steiker reaction is also known as Borodin reaction. According to Hans-Steiker reaction, silver salts of carboxylic acids. This is Ag represents silver. Silver salts of carboxylic acids are treated with bromine in the presence of carbon tetrachloride, 80 degrees C temperature. You will get alkyl halide plus carbon dioxide plus AgBr. This is the general form of Hans-Steiker reaction, students. This is the general form of Hans-Steiker reaction. Silver salts of carboxylic acids are treated with bromine in the presence of carbon tetrachloride to give alkyl halides plus CO2 plus AgBr. In the place of R, if you take ethyl group, CH3, CH2, COO, Ag, then it becomes silver salts of propanoic acid. silver salts of propanoic acid treated with bromine, same in the presence of carbon tetrachloride. The answer will be what, students? CH3CH2Br, ethyl bromide, and this COO will be removed as CO2 plus AgBr. In this way, you can prepare aliphatic alkyl halide. For example, if you take silver salt of benzoic acid, treated with bromine, don't wait for me, students, write down the product. What will be the product? Bromobenzene plus CO2 plus AgBr. So, bromobenzene. In this way, we can prepare both aliphatic and aromatic alkyl halides using our Hans-Dyker reaction. These are about the preparations of alkyl halides, students. So, alkyl halides can be prepared from alkanes, alcohols, and using Hans-Dyker reactions. Right. Let us move into the next topic, students. What does alkyl halides undergo? Which type of reactions does alkyl halides undergo? I already discussed. Alkyl halides undergo two types of reactions, right? One is elimination reactions. The other one are nucleophilic substitution reaction. In this session, let us discuss about elimination reactions first. Elimination reactions. Here, what are elimination reactions? Elimination reactions are those reactions in which atoms or groups are removed from the molecules and they are neither replaced by another atoms or group. Right? What are elimination reactions? In these reactions, atoms are removed, but they are neither replaced. They are not at all replaced. So, our alkyl halides undergo elimination reactions. Actually, elimination reactions are of two types. They are E1 and E2. E1 means unimolecular elimination reaction. E2 means bimolecular elimination reactions. E1 means unimolecular elimination reactions. E2 means bimolecular elimination reactions. What does the words unimolecular and bimolecular represents? Let us discuss about that. First, let us take E1. E1 is nothing but what, students? Unimolecular elimination reactions. E1. What it represents? Unimolecular elimination reactions. I am writing the name of reaction shortcut, students. Write it down. Unimolecular elimination reactions. In this unimolecular elimination reactions, the word unimolecular represents that the rate of the reaction depends only on the concentration of alkyl halide, but not nucleophile. It means it depends only on the one atom, right? One molecule, right? For example, if you take tertiary butyl chloride, and treat it with KOH, what happens? Here we have to eliminate. What happens? If you add KOH, hydrogen from any of these three methyl groups, one of the hydrogen, and chlorine from here will be removed. Let me show you, for example, CH2H. If you write like this, this HCl will be removed and you will get CH3C double bond CH2, CH3 double bond CH2, CH3. You result in a alkene. Okay, what you are observing? Elimination. We are eliminating a group. Okay, HCl. We are eliminating hydrogen atom and chlorine atom. We are not replacing with any other atom, no. Here, the single bond is converted into double bond. That means, in elimination reactions, saturated compounds are converted into unsaturated compounds. In this reaction, the rate of the reaction depends only on the concentration of alkyl halide. That's why it is called unimolecular. The rate of the reaction depends only on the concentration of alkyl halide. That's why it is called unimolecular. Okay, students. Unimolecular elimination reactions are generally seen in tertiary alkyl halides. Generally observed in tertiary alkyl halides. Make note of it, students. Unimolecular elimination reactions takes place in tertiary alkyl halides. For example, take tertiary butyl chloride treated with KOH results in alkene. That means elimination reaction results in conversion of saturated compounds to unsaturated compounds. Now, let us discuss the second reaction. Bimolecular elimination reactions. What are the reactions, students? Bimolecular elimination. Are you making note of it, students? Bimolecular elimination reaction. The word bimolecular represents that in these reactions, the rate of the reactions depends both on the concentration of alkyl halide and the reagent you add. Sorry, in the last case I told nucleophile, not nucleophile, reagent. The rate of the reaction depends both on the concentration of alkyl halide and the reagent you add. Okay, that represents biomolecular. Generally, biomolecular elimination reactions in the case of alkyl halides will be takes place in primary alkyl halides. Takes place in primary alkyl halide. Let us see an example. CH3CH2Cl, ethyl chloride. When it is treated with KOH, it gives, what is the answer, students? From this, we will eliminate chlorine. And from this, hydrogen is eliminated. You should not eliminate hydrogen and chlorine from the same carbon atom. That is not correct. You are already eliminating chlorine. So, you should eliminate hydrogen from the next carbon, adjacent carbon. So, if you write CH3 like CH2H, H and Cl will be removed like this and result in an alkene. CH2 double bond CH2. Result in an alkene. CH2 double bond CH2. Here, the saturated compounds are converting into unsaturated compound, and the rate of the reaction depends both on the concentration of alkyl halide and the concentration of KOH. Here in this case, the rate of the reaction depends on both on the concentration of alkyl halide and the concentration of KOH. That's why these reactions are called bimolecular elimination reactions, bimolecular elimination reactions. So, let us move into the next reactions. What are those, students? Next reactions are nucleophilic substitution reactions. Nucleophilic substitution reactions, right? What does the word substitution says? We are replacing one atom by another atom. Substitute means replacement of one atom by another atom in a molecule results in substitution reactions. What is nucleophilic substitution reaction? Nucleophilic means nucleophiles are nothing but electron rich species. For example, OH minus, NH2, CN minus, etc. So, replacement of an atom by a nucleophile or replacement of nucleophile by another nucleophile results in nucleophilic substitution reactions. In this case of alkyl halides, we replace X halogen atom by a nucleophile. That results in nucleophilic substitution reactions. This is because of the highly polarized bond of CX. I have already discussed about that, right? This results in nucleophilic substitution reactions, right? Nucleophilic substitution reactions are, students, defined as the reactions in which an atom or a group is replaced by a nucleophile. In this case of alkyl halide, the halogen atom, the halide atom is replaced by a nucleophile, results in nucleophilic substitution reactions. Nucleophilic substitution reactions are again of two types. Nucleophilic substitution reactions are of again of two types, students. They are SN1 and SN2. SN1 and SN2. SN1 means unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions, and SN2 means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. SN1 means unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. SN2 means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. Write the extended forms of it, students. So in this reaction, in this halogen compounds chapter, SN1 and SN2 reactions are very, very, very important. They may be asked for the essay question. So this concept is very important. Please listen carefully. Okay. SN1, SN2. One represents unimolecular, means the rate of the reaction depends only on one molecule. Two represents bimolecular, means the rate of the reaction depends only on not one molecule, depends both on concentration of alkyl halide and the nucleophile, concentration of the alkyl halide and the reagent, right? Let us discuss in detail about SN1 and SN2. Let me start SN1 reaction. Let me start about SN1 reaction. What is SN1? Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Write the full form of that. Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution. Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Right. In this case, what happened? The rate of the reaction depends only on the concentration of alkyl halide. So, hence it is called as unimolecular. In this SN1 reaction, the mechanism takes place in two steps. Right. Slow step and fast step, right? In slow step, ionization of alkyl halide takes place. In slow steps, ionization of alkyl halide takes place. Hence, it is called RDS, means rate determining step. In fast step, attack of nucleophile or formation of the product takes place. Attack of nucleophile or the formation of the product takes place. and we will know about the energy profile diagrams, stereochemistry and examples of SN1 reaction also, right? If you know these important things, you can understand the remaining thing, right? If you know these important things, you can understand the remaining thing, right? Let us move into the next topic. Mechanism of SN1 reaction, right? Mechanism of SN1 reaction. If you take alkyl halide, what happens? In the first step, ionization of alkyl halide takes place. In the first step, ionization of alkyl halide takes place. In the second step, formation of product or the attack of nucleophile, right? Ionization of alkyl halide means if you take an alkyl halide, it will be ionized to carbocation and halide ion. In the second step, this carbocation is treated with a nucleophile to form our product. Okay, let us focus on the first step. First step is called a slow step. Second step is very fast step. It takes place very fastly. First step is very slow. Hence, it is called as rate determining step. Okay, that's why the rate of the reaction depends only on the concentration of alkyl halide, because that unimolecular name has come from the rate. The rate depends only on concentration of one molecule, only alkyl halide. That's why it is known as unimolecular, I have already told. So here carbocation is formed and then a halide ion. Here SN1 reaction is mostly preferred in tertiary alkyl halides. So let us discuss, why tertiary alkyl halides? Why not primary, secondary? Of course, secondary also, but it is most preferred in tertiary alkyl halides because the reactivity of alkyl halides towards SN1 reaction will be same as the stability of carbocation, because tertiary carbocations are more stable than secondary than primary. In the same way, reactivity of alkyl halides towards SN1 reaction is more. Tertiary alkyl halides are more than secondary than primary. Why is this so? Let me explain. What happens in tertiary and secondary and primary? For example, if you take a tertiary alkyl halide, right? If you take a tertiary alkyl halide, of course, a secondary, of course, a primary. What happens? If you observe in tertiary alkyl halides, the three methyl groups are electron releasing groups. They release electrons towards the tertiary carbon. This carbon is called tertiary carbon because this carbon is connected to three other carbons. So the electron density on tertiary carbon is increased, so that the greater will be the repulsion between carbon and halogen bond. So that halogen can be easily removed in this case. This electron releasing groups is related to the concept inductive effect, right? See, students, what is the effect here? Inductive effect. This is according to the principle of inductive effect plus I effect. Okay, in this case only two methyl groups are released. So electron density is not more when compared to tertiary compound. In this case only one. So it is not, electron density is not that much more. So tertiary compounds prefer SN1 reaction rather than secondary and primary alkyl halides. Let us discuss with an mechanism. For example, if you take a tertiary alkyl halide, or I can explain with the formation of tertiary alcohol. Why tertiary compounds are more preferred, I'll explain with the preparation of alkyl halide. For example, if you take CH3, OH, CH3. What is the name of this compound, students? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 3-methyl-butane-2-ol. If you consider, why? They prefer only tertiary compounds. Okay. What happens? Why is it so? Let us discuss. 3-methyl-butane-2-ol. They prefer tertiary compounds. But this is a secondary compound, right? OH group is connected to the carbon, which is connected to two other compounds. But the product formed is tertiary. Why is it so? Tertiary carbocations are why preferred? Because although if you take secondary compounds, let me explain. If you do protonation for that, this OH and H will be terminated as water molecules. So the positive charge will be here. You will get CH3, CH, CH3, CH2 plus and CH3. Okay. The plus charge carrying carbon is a what carbon? Secondary carbon, because it is connected to two other carbons only. What happens here is 1, 2 hydrogen shift takes place. 1, 2 hydrogen shift takes place. Like this. What happens? CH3, CCH3, CH2, CH3 plus. The secondary carbocation has undergone 1, 2 shift, and a tertiary carbocation is formed. So, if you take secondary compounds also, tertiary carbocations are formed as intermediates. So, that's why we prefer tertiary compounds rather than secondary and primary. So, this is treated with, for example, some nucleophile. You will get CH3C, CH3 nucleophile, CH2, CH3. You can place chlorine, fluorine, bromine. I mean, in the preparation of alkyl halides also, if they undergo SN1 mechanism, they prefer tertiary compounds. If you take secondary compounds, if the secondary carbocations are formed, they may undergo 1, 2 shift and rearrangements also to form tertiary carbocations and then finally product. That's why I have explained another example which is related to alkyl halides. Right? Let me discuss about the mechanism of the mechanism has been completed right now. Let me discuss about the stereochemistry. What happens in the stereochemistry of alkyl halides? Please listen carefully, students. It is very interesting and you have to know it exactly, right? If you observe the stereochemistry of SN1 reaction, if you take an alkyl halide, okay, if you treat substitute with a nucleophile, a racemic mixture is formed, right? Because the intermediate carbocation will have planar structure. So, if you take an alkyl halide, it undergo ionization to form a carbocation. The entering nucleophile, since the formed intermediate is a planar molecule, the nucleophile may attack from front side to form a compound like this, back side, and also front side to form a compound like this. What are these two compounds, students? They are mirror images. So they are what? Racemic mixture. We know the stereochemistry, right? They are left hand side and right hand side. They becomes racemic mixture, right? If you take alkyl halide, carbocation is formed. Since it is a planar molecule, carbocation is a planar molecule, the nucleophile may attack from front side and back side, both the side. So you will get two products. So the racemic mixture is formed. So that means if you take a optically active compound, racemic mixture is formed indicates it is not optically active. If you take an optically active compound, according to stereochemistry of SN1 reaction, optically inactive compound has to be formed, but it is not taking place. But it is not is in practice. We are not getting exactly inactive compound, optically inactive compound. Why is it so? Because in stereochemistry of SN1 reaction, the main point is inversion plus partial racemization is taking place. In this compound, inversion plus partial racemization is taking place. Why is it so? Let us discuss. You can understand here itself. When alkyl halide is treated, ionized, you are getting a carbocation. So, what we are understanding, the halogen ion is lived completely. But in this case, what happens? The halogen ion, of course, it has been dissociated from alkyl halide, but it is not leaving alkyl halide completely. It is not leaving the alkyl halide completely. Okay, you understood? The alkyl halide which undergo ionization. So, carbocation has to be formed in the first step. Of course, the halide ion is dissociated, but it is not leaving the carbocation completely. I mean, it is shielding the front position of the carbocation. It is shielding the front position of the carbocation. So that these molecules are, of course, if you consider as inverted molecules, these molecules are with retention. Inverted molecules are formed more. Inverted molecules are formed more than molecules with retention. Why? Because the front position is shielded by the halogen atom, so that the nucleophile cannot attack easily to form a product through front side. It easily forms the product through back side, so that number of molecules are formed with inversion rather than retention. That's why in the stereochemistry of SN1 reaction, inversion plus partial racemization is taking place. Let me give an example. You understood the word inversion plus partial racemization, students? For example, if you treat with water and ethanol, what happens? You will get a product like this, C2H5HOHCH3, with same configuration, right? The bromine is this side. So the OH nucleophile is also this side. This is the product with retention plus here. In this case, the OH group is opposite to the bromine which is leaving backside. So this is the molecule with inversion. Inversion is formed 83%. Retention is formed 17%. So the net inversion is 66%. For example, if you take 100 molecules, so 80 molecules are inverted, so they are separated product. 20 molecules are with retention. If you take 100 molecules, for example, 80 molecules with retention, 20 molecules, 80 molecules with inversion is formed. 20 molecules with retention, 20 molecules with retention, the net inversion will be 20 molecules of retention molecules will combine with 20 molecules of inversion molecules to form racemic mixture. So the net inversion will be 60%, the remaining. You have to understand like this. Retention inversion molecules are formed more than retention molecule. Okay. Energy profile diagram of SN1 reaction. Energy profile diagram of SN1 reaction. Energy profile diagram. Right? In this axis, you take energy. Here, progress of reaction. The diagram will be like this. I am not a good artist, students. Please adjust for yourself. Here we will take alkyl halide. Okay. Here in this case, alkyl halide will be dissociated. This is carbocation. And this, in this place, the nucleophile will attack with the carbocation. Okay, to form a product. Okay. So this will be your, okay, this will be your transition state 1, this will be your transition state 2, this is carbocation. If you write this way enough, if you write in this way enough, you need not write like me, I wrote it now, R plus X minus like that. If you simply write the energy profile diagram like this, it is enough. Let us explain. This is the reactant position. We will take reactants here. The product, this indicates the formation of product. This indicates the starting progress of the reaction. Reactants. We are taking reactants, right? This is transition state 1. Transition state 1 relates to ionization of alkyl halide. Since this step is highly endothermic, hence it has high energy peak. Here carbocation, it indicates the carbocation formation, and here formation of product, progress of formation of product. This step is highly exothermic, so it indicates the lower peak. Higher peak is due to high endothermic reaction, ionization of alkyl halide. Formation of product is an, or attack of nucleophile is an highly exothermic reaction. It is indicated by a lower peak. This is an higher peak and this one is a lower peak. Understood? This place is of carbocation and the energy of reactants will be always lower than lower. Reactants will be higher and the energy of products will be lower. In this way, you have to explain the energy profile diagram. And here we'll have what energy, students? Energy of activation. The energy of activation will be high in this case. The energy of activation will be low in this case. Okay. And very low in this case. Right. Today we have discussed about SN1 reaction. Right. If they ask a question about SN1 reaction, you have to write the definition of SN1 reaction. You have to write the mechanism of SN1 reaction. You have to write the stereochemistry of SN1 reaction. And finally, you have to close it the answer with energy profile diagram of SN1 reaction. What are the terms you have to remember, students, for writing an SN1? If they ask to write unimolecular elimination reaction, if they ask to write unimolecular elimination reaction, so first definition, rate of a reaction, Next mechanism. Next, why tertiary carbocations are taken rather than secondary primary with an example. Next, you have to explain about the stereochemistry. Please underline the word inversion plus partial racemization, students. Please underline the word inversion plus partial racemization, students. Okay, you have to write the whole story about that, right? And finally, you have to close the answer with energy profile diagram. So, to write an SN1 unimolecular elimination reaction answer, you have to explain all these terms. Then the SN1 reaction has been completely understood. So, please concentrate on stereochemistry. Please concentrate why tertiary carbocations are taken rather than primary and secondary. Okay, let me conclude the SN1 reaction with an example, students. CH3 Br gives CH3 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 OH. If the question is asked like this, what type of reaction it takes place, first bit. Second point is which mechanism. So the answers will be, it is an SN1 reaction. The mechanism is unimolecular. The mechanism takes place in two steps. It undergoes through SN1 mechanism. It is a SN1 reaction. It undergoes through SN1 mechanism. And what is the intermediate formed? If they ask what is the intermediate formed, so tertiary carbocation. If they ask what happens in stereochemistry, inversion plus racemization. Inversion plus partial racemization. Okay, students. I hope you have understood SN1 reaction. If you understood SN1 reaction, you can easily understand SN2 reaction. We'll discuss in later session. Thank you very much, students.